Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, this joy. That the trial of your faith, being more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto the praise and the honor and to the glory of the appearing of Jesus Christ, whom having not yet seen, ye love, in whom, though now ye see him not, yet believe, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory. 1 Peter 1, 7 through 8. In life, we all have weights and troubles. It can be explained like this. Things that are happening around us, such as the economic uncertainty, family turmoil, safety and security. Then there are things that are happening to us, such as physical problems, sickness and diseases, ongoing medical conditions. Then there are emotional issues, fear and anxiety and depression. Yet the Bible speaks of joy over 150 times. Joy is labeled as one of the fruit of the Spirit. It is second only to love. Romans 14 puts it like this, for the kingdom of God is not in meat and drink, but in righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost is the kingdom of God. If we are in the kingdom, then we are supposed to have joy. Child of God, there's more for you today than that which you're living with. Can I talk to you about this joy? This joy was not given by the world. I did not receive it by alcohol, drugs, entertainment, or by sin. This joy was not given by things, not by a house, a car, possessions, or money. I did not receive it by friends, relationships, and experiences, nor by family, parents, spouse, or children. Nor did I receive this joy by the devil. So if they didn't give it to me, it is only logical for me to say they didn't give it so they can take it away. 2 Corinthians 4, Paul says, but we have this treasure in earthen vessel that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken, cast down, but not destroyed. Let's analyze what state Paul was in when he wrote this. He was lonely, suffering, in bondage, through trials and struggles, yet he was able to say, for it is written, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither have it entered into the hearts of man, the things that God had prepared for them that love him. Can I talk to you about this joy? This joy is my comfort, it's my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. This joy is my reward. The word said, they that sow in tears shall reap in joy. This joy is not only for me, but is also for you. 1 John 1 reminds us that these things I write unto you, that your joy may be full. This joy is based on a relationship with Jesus Christ through his Spirit that is in you. The word says joy comes in the morning. Can I tell somebody today that Calvary was that morning? Joy comes when you experience Calvary for yourself. You might not be able to explain it with your mouth. Nobody will know you've got joy unless you express it. How do you express joy? You express it by smiling. You express it by singing, clapping your hands, jumping, running, and even dancing. I remember when Jamaica qualified for the first time in 1998 for the World Cup. The entire country was in a frenzy. People were crying, hugging, shouting, and dancing. Even enemies were rejoicing together. They were expressing the feeling that they had. Can I say this to you, child of God? This world remains consistent in that it's not going to change from being who it is. We saw this a few days ago. A cultural icon lost his battle with cancer. Speaking of Chadwick Boseman, the Black Panther, if you will, he died, but though we heard some tributes, the world kept on moving. The Black Panther died, but the Prime Minister didn't cancel the election in September. The Black Panther died, but Trump did not cancel the elections in November. The world is consistent. It's gonna keep moving whether you're here or not. Amidst everything that is happening, people are still hating each other. People are still malicing each other. People are still grudging. And so if the world can be so consistent as to who it is, then I have a choice to make. I choose to walk with joy. Therefore, my supervisor can't affect me. My co-worker can't mess with me. We find that the COVID cases are increasing. Now you can be arrested for being on the road without a mask. So much stress, so much strain. I have a choice to make. I choose this joy. And when the devil comes in like a flood, I can look him in the face and say, not today, devil, because I've got this joy. The thought of the day. This joy is based on a relationship with Jesus Christ through His Spirit that is in you. God bless you today. In Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.